number 99, Anthony Talpa. He will be hitting for tonight's pitcher, number 19, Clay Oates. First baseman, number 6, Nick Talpa. Right fielder, number 12, Riley Fisher. Second baseman, number 3, Gabe Tefelski. Third base, Stephen Hart, number 4. Center fielder, number 18, Landon Carter. And rounding out the Leopards tonight is left fielder, number 8, Luke Puckett. Head coach, Tim Sims. Welcome to Key West, gentlemen. Let's hear it for your Key West Conks. Leading off tonight, playing third base, number 14, Wyatt Kuhn.
Well, it is another beautiful night in Key West. The temperature's starting to dip a little bit. Wind is whipping again today, but not quite as bad as it was last night. Welcome back here to the friendly confines of Rex Weech Field. I'm Rick Lopez, now joined by my broadcast partner, Judd Wise. And Judd, Conks need a win, and they want to avoid, for the first time this year, losing 5 straight after losing last night 10-3. This is the third time we've had a 4-game losing streak, but just want to get in the win column, and it won't be easy because we saw this Hernando team last night, and they're pretty good.
They swing the bats. There's no question about it. 16 hits last night. You know, and we're starting Burnham tonight, Rick, and I really think this game might be decided in inning one. If we can do something where we can, you know, even if they get a couple guys on but not give up any runs in that first inning, I think mentally that will be the key. I really think the first inning tonight is going to be the key to this game.
And we're getting close to start time here as the sun has set behind the bank building on Kennedy Drive. It's time for the national anthem, so let's take one more two-minute timeout. When we come back, we'll introduce you to the starting lineups and have the first pitch. It's Conk Baseball here on The Zone, WAVK 97.7.
The Flash would say, juega pelota.
All right, let's introduce you to the starting lineups. Game 2 of this 2-game set between Key West and Hernando. And the starting lineups are brought to you each and every game by Fausto's Food Palace, the Conks' hometown supermarket for over 95 years. 2 great locations to serve all us Conks on Fleming and White Street. It's Fausto's for all your grocery needs, and you'll find them online at Fausto's.com. First for the Hernando Leopards, 16-1 on the year, leading things off playing shortstop Dylan Dufilly. Batting second, the catcher Dylan Schatzel. Batting third, the DH Anthony Talpa. In the cleanup spot, the first baseman Nick Talpa. Batting fifth in right field, Riley Fisher. Batting sixth, the second baseman Gabe Tafowski. Batting seventh, the third baseman Stavens Hart. Batting eighth, the center fielder Landon Carter. And batting ninth in left field, Luke Puckett. On the hill for the Panthers is Clay Oates. For your hometown, Key West Conks, now 5-12 on the year. Leading things off, playing third base, Wyatt Kuhn. Batting second, the center fielder Landon Lowe. Batting third, the shortstop Preston Hurst. Batting fourth and catching Daniel Varela. Batting fifth, the DH tonight, Trevor Zelch. Batting sixth, the first baseman Michael Alfonso. Batting seventh in right field, Jack Haggard. Batting eighth in left field, Nate Barroso. And batting ninth, the second baseman, Kai Smith. On the hill for the Conks, the freshman, Jacob Burnham. Those are your starting lineups brought to you by Fausto's Food Palace. Now it's time for the first pitch of the game, brought to you by the College of the Florida Keys. And Jacob Burnham delivers that first pitch to Dylan Dufilly. It's high, ball one. The 1-0. Swung on and lifted out there into left center field, into the gap already for Dufilly off the base of the fence. Picking it up off the bounce is Nate Barroso. He's going to try and turn this into a triple, and he'll get there. Well, they had 16 hits in the ball game, and they start off with the second pitch here tonight, deep into the gap in left center field by Dufilly. It's a leadoff triple, and they're off and running.
Yeah, no question. They picked up where they left off last night. I mean, he just took that fastball, ripped it to left center field. No chance for Barroso or Lowe to get to there, and slides in with a triple.
And that'll bring up their catcher, Dylan Schatzel. Out of the stretch already is Burnham, and this ball is swung on and popped up into shallow right field. Long way to go for the second baseman. He dives for it, almost collides with Jack Haggard. Nobody comes up with it, and he's going to end up into second base with an RBI double. Wow. These guys swing. And that one, listen, that was just one of those Texas leaguers out there kind of in no man's land in shallow right field. The best guy to have a chance at it was Kai Smith, who's playing second base today. Makes a diving effort for it. Almost collides with Jack Haggard, who also dove in there, but nobody could come up with it. And they've got a 1-0 lead here. Wow.
And they're halfway to hitting for the cycle.
Double and a triple, and they already got a run on the board. And, Judd, I haven't even finished, the first pitch stuff, which is, by the way, the first pitch was brought to you by College of the Florida Keys. Hey, students, you can earn college credit at no cost while you're still in high school. Dual enrollment classes at the College of the Florida Keys can help you get ahead and save money. Learn more by going to cfk.edu, and they just keep swinging. Anthony Talpa lifts this one almost in the same spot, and it is in the same spot. Drops between Haggard and Kai again. They're going to wave. Schatzel round from second base. He's going to score, and it's an RBI single for Talpa. And that ball landed right in the same exact spot that Schatzel put it in.
Yeah, and the unfortunate is that, no communication between the right fielder and the second baseman. They just kind of looked at each other. Coach threw his hands up in the air, and now they're up 2-0.
All right, so a triple, a double, and a single. 1, 2, 3, 4 pitches have been thrown.
Yeah, if they hit the home run, they hit for the cycle.
My goodness gracious. Boy, could we use a double play right now. Here's Nick Talpa, the first baseman. He actually swings and fouls it away. So their first pitch swinging here tonight. See if the Conks can kind of change things up. Don't give them anything to nothing fat there on that first pitch. No balls and one strike. As this pitch is high, ball one. So Jacob Burnham getting the start here today for Key West. This is his fifth start of the year. 1-2 with an ERA of 5.63 coming into the game. As this one sails high, ball two. 13 2/3 innings, 23 hits, 13 runs, 11 earned runs, 9 base on balls, and 12 Ks. Those were his stats before we threw the first pitch here today, but has given up 3 hits here and 2 runs already. This ball is swung on and lifted into right field, and losing it was Jack Haggard out there. He came in and then realized the ball was going to get over his head. It's going to drop in for a triple. They're going to try and send the runner from first. Here's the play at the plate, and they don't get the tag on him. Good throw home from the cutoff man, the second baseman, Kai Smith, as he fires home, but sliding underneath the tag was Anthony Talpa, and he had no choice but to come home because Nick Talpa saw a triple all the way, and he almost caught up to him over at third base.
Yeah, Nick kind of forced that issue on either his brother or cousin right there, but he was lucky to get in. But they got it. Just like that, they're up 3-0.
Wow. All right, this is getting silly here.
And, you know, the other thing, Rick, too, right now, you know, we got that weird kind of sky right
now. And I think that's what affected
it. That's a big factor.
Yeah, there's still sunlight here that always has played a role over the years when we have the time change. As Fisher looks at this one high for a ball. One ball and one strike to Riley Fisher.
Been nightmares in the right field tonight.
1-1. Wild pitch high over the catcher's head, but bounces off the netting and right back to Varela. So the Leopards, who had 16 hits in the game last night, every player in the lineup had at least one hit in the game for Hernando last night. And the first four guys that come to the plate here in the top of the first inning have hits. We've had two triples, a double, and a single. And three runs are in. This pitch is in there for strike two. We count it 2-2. So Burnham just needs to settle down here, get that first out. This ball is swung on and chop foul back toward the on-deck circle on the visitor side. That's the first base side. Jacob's last outing came last Friday up in Sanford, where he did get good quality. He worked three innings in the game against South Lake Christian, gave up one unearned run. Two hits, he struck out three and walked nobody. This ball is slapped down to second base. That's Kai Smith. He'll go ahead and get the out over at first. But Nick Talpa is going to come home and score their fourth run on the RBI. Fielder's choice scored 4-3 on the out, and there's your first out.
All right, so now nobody's on
now
base.
Now just calm down, yeah.
Exactly.
Calm down. Let's get into this. Here's Gabe Tafalski, their second baseman, swings at this pitch and fouls it out of play for strike one.
And you're right, Rick. They don't waste any time. They're
swinging at the first pitch.
Yeah, they're ready for that first pitch fastball.
That's what I'm sure the coach had told them, go out and swing. And that's what they did. Each batter, I think, has swung at the first pitch. Pitch is in there for a strike. So Tafalski now in the hole, no balls and two strikes. Here's the 0-2. Oh,
see
nice
you,
breaking ball. He'll strike him out. So now two quick outs, first strikeout for Burnham. Jacob's last start actually came 2 weeks ago, March 20th, against Coral Reef here on that Saturday night that Coral Reef came down here. But Jacob only lasted two innings that day, five runs scored on him, four were earned on seven hits. He struck out two and walked one and took the loss.
Wow, where was that pitch?
Stevens Hart comes up to the plate, their third baseman, and apparently that pitch missed for
a
ball. And he didn't swing. The 1-0. Off-speed pitch in there for a strike. Let's set the Conk defense for you because it's changed again here tonight. Daniel Varela behind the plate. Michael Alfonso at first. Kai Smith at second. Wyatt Coons at third base. Preston Hurst, where he's played his first 2 years. He's back at shortstop. His first game at shortstop this year. That ball has been fouled away. In front of the Conk dugout for strike two. Nate Barroso in left. Landon Lowe is in center. And Jack Haggard is in right field. The 1-2, swing and a miss. They'll strike him out. So back-to-back K's end the inning, but Hernando picks up where they left off last night as they pick up four runs on four hits. There were no Key West errors and no one left on base. So the Conks find themselves in a hole as we start this ball game. We'll head to the bottom of the first. Key West coming up for their first cuts. It's Hernando 4, Key West nothing. Back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WAVK. right, the Conks find themselves in a hole already as we move to the bottom of the first. Key West trailing Hernando here by the score of 4-0 as the Leopards come out. First pitch swinging, score 4 runs on 4 hits in the top of the first inning. Wyatt Kuhn's going to get an opportunity to be the leadoff man. The Conk third baseman will await the first pitch from Clay Oates, a big righty, and he delivers this one high, ball one. Let's reset that Conk batting order for you. 1, 2, 3 guys, Wyatt Kuhn, followed by Landon Lowe, then Preston Hurst. 4, 5, and 6 guys, Daniel Varela, Trevor Zelch, Michael Alfonso. 7, 8, and 9, Jack Haggard, Nate Barroso, and Kai Smith. This pitch gets in there for a strike. So Clay Oates is the starter. He's a senior. Another tall pitcher here on this staff, 6'4". They list him at 180 pounds.
That would be Soka Dwight.
Yeah. Big swing and a miss. Strike two. Wasn't the starter last night 6'4 as well?
Yeah, but he was like 195. Yeah. He had a little more meat on his bones. This is an all arms, all legs kind of guy.
Yeah, he's coming at you here with the big slow breaking ball in there. Strike three. He'll strike Kuhn out looking. Conks come into today with a 229 batting average.
Landon Lowe, number
Kuhn
four.
Batting 250 starting today. Strikes out here. And that'll bring up Landon Lowe, Key West top hitter. Landon batting 368. He's having a marvelous year at the plate. Scored 15 runs. He's got 15 RBIs. Leads Key West in that category. Also in doubles with 7. And he'll take that pitch in there for strike one. Got a high on-base percentage of 471. He's really turned it up here in the second half of the season. His senior year. Lowe's going to Indian River. Takes that pitch in there for strike two. No balls, 2 strikes here to Landon. The 0-2 swung on and fouled over just past the first base dugout and out of play. Count remains no balls and 2 strikes. If you're new to the Rex, big ballpark here. 315 down the left field line, 306 down the right field line. We've got the massive power alleys, 406 in left, 410 in right. Straightaway center field where the football bleachers come into play, it's 360 if you can get it out there. That pitch misses ball one. 1 ball, 2 strikes here to Landon. There's decent room in foul territory down the lines. Not a lot of room at all behind home plate. Grand old ballpark that opened up in 1952. The 1-2. And you check his swing. Yes, he did on the high fastball. And the count moves to 2-2. So Landon will adjust his helmet, get himself set up again as he bats from that right-hand side. Preston Hurst on deck for Key West. Clay Oates, the big righty, comes home. There's a high breaking ball. Did that hit him? Count was 2-2.
That's what I had.
Did it?
To hit him, huh?
No.
No?
He thought, Landon thought it was ball four, but the count was 2-2.
Okay.
The way he ran down there, I thought maybe it grazed off the rim of his helmet, but just a wild pitch that goes back to the backstop for ball three. So Landon's got to come all the way back to the plate, pick up his stick again. Count's now full, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Interesting here, Oates working out of the stretch. And he delivers that one low and outside. Landon takes a hack and he'll strike him out. So back-to-back K's. The Conks have struck out quite a few times this year, coming into tonight's game, 134 strikeouts. The first two guys strike out here. Here's Preston Hurst. Preston batting 255 on the year. Looks at this slow off-speed pitch, sail high. Ball one. Preston leads the team in runs scored with 19. He's got 7 RBIs. He's got 1 of the 2 Key West home runs. And he got hit by another pitch last night. He's been hit 12 times now this year. 1 shy of the record at Key West High School. This ball has popped up on the infield on the left-hand side. The shortstop, Dylan Dufilly, calls everybody off as he comes on to the infield turf grass and makes the grab. And the Conks will go very quickly and quietly here in the bottom of the first inning. So for Key West, no runs on, no hits. There were no errors and nobody left. We got one in the books. It's Hernando 4, Key West nothing. We're back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WAVK. Welcome back, everybody. It's Conk Baseball here on a beautiful Saturday night in Key West. A little chilly, Judd.
Yes, it is.
I got the weather.
I'm
right
going to say 71. 68 already?
Well, my phone is saying 73, so I think you're both wrong.
I think your phone's wrong anyways.
Top of the second we go. Hernando leads by the score of 4-0. Jacob Burnham back out for his second inning of work. Trying to lay down the bunt is Landon Carter, their center fielder. And again, first pitch putting the bat out there. Carter bunts it hard, though, right back to the pitcher. So good job for Jacob Burnham. Gets on it quick, and Judd gets the first out there.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, when you're a left-handed pitcher, you fall towards the third base side, and that's where the bunt went. He was able to fall that way, scoop it up, and make a great throw to first.
Here's Luke Puckett. Puckett will take that pitch in there for a strike. He's their left fielder. 21 pitches in the first inning for Burnham. Got roughed up at the start of the ball game. 4 consecutive hits, a couple of triples. And then after the RBI fielder's choice, he retired the next 2. So he did retire 3 in a row after those first 4 hits. As that pitch will get in there, strike 2, including 2 strikeouts. He hasn't walked anybody yet. So this is a guy we're going to be seeing a lot of over the next few years. Just a freshman, Jacob Burnham, comes home with this pitch.
See ya, baby.
Strike him out. As he paints the outside portion of the plate. And that's his 3rd K in the last 4 batters, Judd.
Yep, good job right now.
All right, back to the top of the order. Here's Dylan Dufilly, who got it started for the Leopards with a triple to start off the ball game and scored their first run. He had, interesting note, he had a triple in last night's game as well. He had 2 hits last night, a couple of RBIs. He started tonight with a triple and scored their first run. But there are 2 quick outs. As a look at this one, low, ball 1. Time for tonight's fashion report, brought to you by Ramona's Conk Creations in Searstown. Ramona's is celebrating 50 years of Conk pride. For your Key West Conks, they're wearing the, as that pitch gets in there for a strike, the red pullover top today with Key West in gray across the front, trimmed in white. As that pitch is low, ball 2. Gray numbers on the back, trimmed in white. They're wearing white pants with red pinstripes, the red leggings, and the all-red cap with the connecting KW in white. As this ball is lifted foul and out of play for strike 2. For the Hernando Leopards, here's Judd Wise.
Yeah, they've got the purple leggings again. Now they're in an all-gray uniform with purple pinstripe. Their number is in the back, purple outlined in gold. Next pitch, swing and a miss. We'll see ya.
Well, we're gonna have to, we'll finish it when we come back. As Burnham makes quick work of the Leopards here and sends them down 1-2-3 in the top of the second. So no runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on base. We've played an inning and a half. It's Hernando 4, Key West nothing. Back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WAVK. All right, we're back here. It's Conk Baseball on the Zone, 97.7 WAVK. Conk Baseball on the radio, brought to you by Niles Sales and Service, First State Bank of the Florida Keys, Fausto's Food Palace, Domino's Pizza, the Key West Golf Club, College of the Florida Keys, Coolidge's Appliances and TV, Refreshment Services Pepsi, Garrison Bite Marina, Two Friends Patio Restaurant, Florida Keys Electric, Key Plaza Creperie, Ramona's Conk Creations, Mojo's Sports Bar and Bistro, Amerigas, Tavern in Town, VFW Post 3911, CarQuest, and Conk Paint and Body. Great to have you aboard, Rick Lopez, along with Judd Wise, Todd Swafford, producing tonight's ball game. Conks find themselves in an early hole here, but that was a good sign. Judd, Jacob Burnham sending them down 1-2-3, and in the first, that's the first time in these two games that that's happened.
Right. Yeah. We were hoping that would happen in the first inning, but we'll take it in the second inning.
Right. So Jacob settling in. Let's see if we can get the offense going. Conks went 1-2-3 in the bottom of the first. It'll be Daniel Varela, followed by Trevor Zelch and Michael Alfonso. Conk catcher Daniel Varela had a couple of hits in last night's game. Excuse me. We'll dig in there. And he'll look at this pitch high. Ball one. For Varela, he's batting 260 on the year with 10 RBIs, and he has one of those two Conk home runs. That pitch got in there for a strike. This ball is swung on and popped up into right field.
Yeah, they can't see it.
That's another tough one. The right fielder can't see it. The Conks had all kinds of problems in that sky in the top of the first inning. The second baseman, Gabe Trafalski, goes back. He can't find it either, and it's going to drop in for a hit for Daniel Varela. And, this is havoc right now at this time of the game for the right fielders.
Yeah, it's because you just have that sun that's going down. You've got clouds all over the place. It's that hazy, dark sky, and once the ball gets up in there, they can't see it. He immediately threw his hands up in the air like, where is it, where is it?
That was the third hit in this series for Daniel Varela, so good start here for us in the bottom of the second inning. That'll bring up Trevor Zelch, who is in the DH role tonight, looks at this one low, ball one. Trevor has gotten his average right up to 200 now with seven RBIs. Trevor had a hit last night. He went 1-for-4. He'll take a hack at this one and pop this one up, though, in left field.
Oh,
now
they
Luke
can't
Puckett
see it.
Can't
they can't
find
see
it either, it. And it's going to drop behind him. Nobody can see the ball out in the outfield right now, and the Conks get a couple of breaks here, and that's going to end up and go in the books as a double for Trevor Zelch.
Yep.
Looked like Puckett had a bead on it, and then he just completely lost it, and it fell behind him. And hustling with Zelch, he gets the second.
Up number
and Varela now at third.
First baseman, Big Mike Alfonso.
Here's Michael Alfonso, so back-to-back hits. Conk's getting aided by this crazy sky right now here because there's clouds up there, Judd. You could see, you're looking up there, and you just can't see that white ball. And that was very evident on that one, and as Puckett never saw it. Here's Alfonso. He'll look at this one high, ball one. Michael batting just under 200 at 196 with 11 RBIs. He does lead the team in walks with 18. Last night he was 1-for-4 and scored a run. He'll look at this one low, ball two. Clay Oates, the starter for the Leopards, had a quick 1-2-3 inning with a couple of strikeouts, threw only 13 pitches. But here, giving up a single and a double, and the Conks trying to take advantage, them not being able to make the catches out there due to this crazy sky right now. The 2-1, the 2-0, bit high. Whoa, he called that a strike. Yeah. All right, you want to finish the Leopards uniform?
Yeah, you know, as we said, the leggings with the all-gray uniform, but their numbers are in purple outlined. They have Hernando across in purple outlined in gold. All purple hat with a gold H outlined in white.
That ball is fouled out of play down the third baseline for strike two. So there's your fashion report brought to you, of course, by the girls over at Ramona's Conk Creations, Kathy and Tiffany. They're celebrating 50 years of being a school spirit store here in Key West. They're at Searstown, open Monday through Friday from 11 to 5:30 p.m. Whatever you need a T-shirt made on the spot, they'll take care of that. Big swing and a miss, he'll strike him out. He gets Michael to chase one low and outside. That's his third K of the ball game. And by the way, when you go to Ramona's, you can always get
the historical and traditional Conk baseball cap, the all red cap with that famous connecting KW and white. So make sure you pick one up today. Here's Jack Haggard. Boy, Jack also had struggled out there in right field, and everybody's going to struggle out there at this time of the game, and he wants to make up for that here at the plate, and he'll look at this pitch high, ball one. Haggard getting the second straight start in right field. He was on board twice last night without a hit. He worked out a walk. He was hit by a pitch and scored a run. And he looks at this one high, ball two. For Haggard on the year, batting .217 with three RBIs. He's a youngster, only a sophomore. Bats from that left-hand side and looks at this one. It's high. It's off the catcher's mitt. And it goes back to the backstop, but Varela won't try and come home. And the count now, three balls and no strikes. Well, one of the things, and we talked about it in the pregame show with the skipper, Judd, one of the issues throughout 2021 for this Conk baseball team is leaving men on the bases. And that has been a problem throughout the season, and it happened again last night where we left 10 guys out there. You've got to be able to take advantage of this situation here. Both runners in scoring position, we've got to get a couple of them in. That pitch misses outside for ball four. Now the bases are loaded.
Walker Haggard brings up number six.
So Haggard works out the walk. He goes and says hi to his dad, Drew Haggard, coaching over in the first base box. Young Ralph Enriquez coaching over in the third base box. Skipper Ralph Enriquez just outside the dugout looking things over. Walks other coach, Dexter Butler, the head JV coach, on the road today. They were up in Columbus. I haven't gotten a report how the JV did. Dexter, if you're listening on your way home from Miami, let us know how the JV boys did today up there in Miami. Barroso at the plate with the 1-0 count and looks at this one low, ball two. Don't help him out right now.
No, make him throw you a strike. And we're going to have a little timeout right now as the coach is going to come out and talk to him.
Nate batting .231 on the year with three RBIs. This is his 27th plate appearance of the season. Yeah, Tim Sims, the longtime head coach of the Leopards, going to come out and have a word with his entire infield.
Do you know how many years he's been there?
I'm not sure how long he has been there, but he's been there for a while because he's got over 400 career wins.
That's exactly right. That's a long time.
Yeah, and he's coaching at his alma mater, as we told you last night. Him and Steve Vincent, of course, former principal at Poinciana School here. And where's Steve now?
He's over at HOB.
Uh-huh. That's right. He's back over at HOB and a longtime educator here in Key West. Steve Vincent, they were teammates, him and Tim Sims, for Hernando. So that, I guess that'll tell you, you know, because Steve's pretty old now. Bases are juiced. Two balls and no strikes to Barroso. He's taken all the way as that one gets in there for strike one. And looking at Clay Oates, I mean, he's a big guy. He's got a lot of arms and legs coming at you, but he's going to rely on that breaking ball a lot, and he's got a good one. Not going to really overpower you, I don't think, Judd.
No, he's not.
The 2-1, swung on, and that's ripped right up the middle. That's a shot by Nate Barroso. Here comes Varela. He's going to score. They'll hold up Zelch over at third, and here come your Conks gang. Hey, it's a 4-1 game.
Yeah, Nate just sat on that fastball, drilled it right back up the middle, and the center fielder got a good jump on it and was able to make a good throw home. We'll just move one base at a time and we'll take it.
Right, so he picks up an RBI. Zelch moves down to third. Haggard now at second, and the bases remain loaded. So there you go. Cash in when you have the opportunities. And Barroso just did with that single and picked up his fourth RBI. And here's Kai Smith, who bats in the nine hole, playing second base for the first time this year. Looks at that pitch inside, ball one. Top of the order, Wyatt Kuhn on deck. One ball, no strikes. Kuhn will take a hack at this one and foul it out of play. And the count evens up at 1-1. Make sure that we are. No, we're good. Producer Todd Swafford got disconnected for a bit, but he's back with us. The 1-1. is outside. Ball two. Two balls and one strike. And you know the other thing, Judd, is go out and have fun.
Big part
of it. Get to play baseball. Go out and have fun.
Last year we weren't playing it this time. Let's take advantage of it.
You're exactly right. Just have fun. Pitch is high, ball three. You walk him. Another run comes in. 4-1 ball game right now. Conks had the bases loaded. Trevor Zelch over at third. Jack Haggard at second. Nate Barroso at first.
They got a little action in their pen already.
Yeah, they do.
Here we go.
Here's the 3-1. Outside, ball four. He'll walk him. So that's his second walk he's issued this inning. And Kai's going to pick up an RBI. Coming home to score the second run of the ballgame is Trevor Zelch for Key West. It's now 4-2 game. Walk Haggard now at third. Barroso at second. And Kai Smith is over at first. We're back to the top of the order. So Wyatt Kuhn's second look at Clay Oates. Kuhn was a victim of a strikeout looking in the first inning. Kuhn awaits the pitch, and it's called a strike.
And remember, none of this would have happened if we didn't have that strange sky.
We had that high sky, yeah. And balls hit into right field by Varela and Zelch to left field that neither of the outfielders could see. That off-speed, slow breaking ball gets right over the knees and drops off the plate for strike two. Hernando playing at double play depth here with one away, and the base is loaded. Smith takes a hack, rips it up the middle. It's stopped by the shortstop, who flips it out of his glove.
Nice play.
To the second baseman, who then fires over to first, and they score. They turn a fantastic 6-4-3 double play. Dufilli is sliding behind the second base bag, gloves it, flips it out of his glove to Tafalski, who then fires over to first to get that really well-turned 6-4-3 double play and end the Conk rally here in the bottom of the second. But Key West is able to pick up two runs on 1-2-3 hits. There were no errors, and two were left out on the bases. We've played two, got a ball game as we move to the top of the third. It's Hernando 4, Key West 2. Back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WAVK. We move to the top of third. Got a ball game here tonight on this Saturday evening. Hernando leads Key West by the score of 4-2 as the Conks pick up two runs in the bottom of the second inning to cut their lead in half. Jacob Burnham back out on the hill. He's delivered three pitches to Dylan Schotzel, their catcher, and the count is 1-2. This ball is hit hard down to the shortstop. Preston Hurst bobbles it, and that'll be an error. E6. So Hard shot, but right at the shortstop, Preston Hurst, who couldn't glove it, tried to pick it up off the ground by the time he did and got the throw over there not in time. So they get the leadoff man aboard here. And that'll bring up Anthony Talpa, the DH. It's the 2, 3, and 4 guys to start the third inning for Hernando. The Leopards having a terrific year at 16-1. We got to stop in the action here. Something's going on, right? Oh, they got to bring in a runner. They're bringing in a runner for the catcher. And we'll see if I can get that number, Judd. I can't tell.
I can't. Well, back's not to us.
Right, exactly. So that brings up Anthony Talpa. Talpa had an RBI single in his first at bat. And he lifts this one into that same shallow spot in right field and then slipping and falling on the ground, then sticking his glove up on the air with his belly on the turf is Jack Haggard, and he makes the catch.
Wow.
Wow. It is whipping out there. But that time, Haggard was there, Judd,
yep.
But his feet gave way, and he fall flat on his belly, and he sticks his glove up in the air, and he makes the grab anyway. Woo. All right, there's an early candidate, Judd, for the Garrison Bite Marina catch of the day. This ball is chopped foul by Nick Talpa.
Number 11 is pinch running.
All right, so that is Will Taylor. Taylor running for Schatzel.
So he was taken off on the hit and run.
Talpa will swing at this one, chop it down to third. It could have been a double play, but a throw from Kuhn is way high to the second baseman. And that'll be another error, this time E5. That ball, two hop chop right to Kuhn, and he fielded it cleanly, but his throw was way too high for Kai Smith to come down with. Everybody safe, runners on the corners.
Key West playing sloppy baseball right now.
That's, you know, after getting the two runs and just don't want to give away outs.
Oh,
and,
exactly.
And you can't with a team like this. Hernando team 16-1 for last night's win. They've won 7 in a row. They're going to keep hacking. You know that. We just got to make the plays. Here's Riley Fisher. And he'll take that off-speed pitch in there for a strike. Burnham, who had worked a 1-2-3 in the second, should have had a 1-2-3 here in third. Ball is swung on and chopped right in front of the plate and rolls foul. And the count 0-2. Schatzel got on board with an error by the shortstop, and now Talpa on board over at first on the errant throw on the double play attempt. There goes the runner. The pitch is in there. They'll strike him out. And that's strikeout number 2. He'll strike him out looking. That is actually Burnham's 5th strikeout, but that's the 2nd out of the inning. So despite the 2 errors, you're 1 out away from getting out of this mess here. And if you can, that's a big momentum shift right there. As Gabe Tafowski checks a swing on this pitch into the carpet, ball 1. One ball, no strikes. The pitch, swing and a miss. Strike 1. This is gut check time for the freshman, Judd. The 1-1. High fastball, trying to work through the errors and keep them off the scoreboard here in the third. Felski struck out looking back in the first, 0-1. Waits this pitch, sails high, ball 3. Three balls and 1 strike here to the Leopards' second baseman. He'll take a hack at it and rip it foul and over the backstop and into the stadium trailer park. And the count is full. 3 balls and 2 strikes.
A big pitch coming right here.
Huge.
Go get him yourself. And he does.
And he does. Swing and a miss, and he strikes him out. Well, 2 big errors did not end up hurting Key West, as Burnham
comes and strikes out two here in the third. He's got six now in the game. And a great job by the young freshman to get out of that mess. For the Leopards, no runs on no hits. Conks committed two errors, but it ends up not hurting us. And they leave two men out on the base paths. We've played two and a half. It's still Hernando 4, Key West 2. Back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WAVK. On to the bottom of the third we go here. Hernando leading Key West by the score of 4-2. Landon Lowe is going to lead things off for your Conks. It'll be our 2-3 and 4 guys. Lowe followed by Preston Hurst and Daniel Varela. So here we go. Landon, a victim of a strikeout back in the first inning. Clay Oates about to start his third inning of work for the Leopards, and he delivers this one outside. Ball one. Had to throw 25 pitches in that long second inning while he was out on the hill. 38 pitches through two innings for Oates. He's got three Ks and he's walked two. Big swing and a miss. Strike one. Conks picked up two there in that second inning. And see if we can get a couple more going here. One ball, one strike. That pitch gets in there, strike two. Judd, I don't think I gave Hernando's defense for everybody, so let's do that now.
No.
Dylan Schatzel's behind the plate. Nick Talpa at first. Gabe Tafowski at second. Stavens Hart is over at third. Dylan Dufilly is the shortstop. Out in the outfield in left is Luke Puckett. In center field is Landon Carter. And in right, Riley Fisher. So, as I announce those outfielders' names, they'll all breathe a sigh of relief now, Judd, as it's now pretty dark out here.
Yep.
Back to a regular sky as the lights are burning bright here at the Rex now. And takes away that crazy mid-early evening sky out of play here. Conks took advantage of that crazy sky in the second inning that helped bring in those two runs. Two balls and two strikes. Big swing and a miss. He'll get him. So he'll strike out Lowe for the second time tonight. And there's one away for Preston Hurst. Want to wish everyone a happy Easter here on this Easter weekend. You know, I was down at Fausto's Food Palace earlier today, Judd, and got for my family one of those honey glazed hams, spiral hams.
So nice of you, Rick.
Yeah, boy. I can't wait to get into that baby tomorrow night. Here's Preston. He looks at this one high. No, called it a strike. Okay. Thought that one was a little high.
He has to think about it for an hour.
Yeah, he has a bit of a delayed call behind the plate. Two umpire crew here tonight. The 0-1, the off-speed breaking ball. That one gets in there for strike two. No balls and two strikes. Also going to get out and play a little golf tomorrow.
All right.
The Key West Golf Club. Katie Blakeout, my buddy, who's here tonight. We're going out there tomorrow.
Ball is swung on and fouled out of play.
Better be ready to hit everything low below the wind.
Yeah, we're going to deal some wind. And they have been crazy out at the golf course.
They have.
I mean, just slammed. Packed.
Yep. What time's your tee time?
11:15.
All right.
Yeah. Looking forward to getting back out there. I love our golf course and can't wait to play a little tomorrow. Could be a long round with the, you know, how many people are out there. Buddy Kenny said he's played 4 days in a row and it isn't helping his game, Judd.
Yeah, sometimes that's, you play that's too
good.
Much, Kenny.
That's good news for me. One ball, two strikes.
Hungate playing with you?
Yes, Steve Hungate from Niles will be out there. The 1-2 swung on and popped up on the infield on the left side, shortstop. Doesn't really have to move much from his position there and takes a couple of steps to his left a little bit and camps underneath it. That's Dylan Dufilly. He'll make the grab. And there's quickly two away here for the Conks in the third. What do you guys got planned for Easter tomorrow?
Catcher Daniel Varela.
Well, you know, we Jews, we don't usually celebrate Easter tomorrow, so I'll be working around the yard washing the cars. I don't know what what you got planned, but that's what I'll have planned. Okay, now you could ask me what I do during Passover time, you know, but no, not you, Lopez.
Pitch is inside ball one.
You set yourself up.
Yeah,
for
I did. Yeah. Okay. Varela had a single and scored back in the second inning, so he's one for one. He's got three hits in this series.
I'm going to make a ho-ho cake tomorrow. That's
my goal.
There
you go. Okay. This pitch is just a little bit low. Well, two, but, you know, you're the only Jewish person in your household.
Yeah.
Okay, there's a lot of other people over there.
And what's your point?
Yeah. Well, you guys going to have a nice big dinner? Are you going to do something as a family?
No, I don't
think. You're just going to go out and work in the yard?
I'm going to work in the yard, right. Putts with the fishing gear, and, yeah, we'll eat dinner.
Well, you'll eat dinner. This ball swung on and fouled out of play. And the count now at two balls and one strike. But we wish all of you very happy Easter and hope you have wonderful day. I do have one thing I got to get done tonight because I still have two little kids.
Yeah, you got to put some Easter eggs around.
Oh, I do. And I got to run over to the store as soon as we're done here.
You haven't done that yet?
No, I hadn't. And I wanted to do it today. Big swing and a miss, strike two. Man, they were so crowded everywhere today.
Yep.
All the stores. I did make a, before we got to the ballpark, I did make a scouting trip into one of the supermarkets and did find a bunch of stuff that I can go get afterwards.
Okay.
After the game. The ball is slapped into the hole. It's short. Nice play over there by
Dufilly. What a scoop.
This kid is putting on a clinic out there at shortstop as he goes down to one knee in the hole, fires it across the diamond, and a great stretch on the other end there by their first baseman, Nick Talpa. Dufilly has made two spectacular plays and does another one here, and that'll send the Conks down 1-2-3 in the bottom of the third. Tremendous effort there by the shortstop and their first baseman to end this inning. For Key West, no runs on no hits. There were no errors, and nobody left. We've played three. It's Hernando 4, Key West 2. We're back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WADK. Yeah. Oh, it's so great to have you with us. It's Conk Baseball here on the Zone on a beautiful yet windy, kind of chilly night here in the southernmost city. Hernando leads 4-2 as we start the top of this fourth inning. Stavins Hart leading off for the Leopards, swings at the first pitch, chops it down to second base, which is fielded cleanly by Kai Smith. He goes over to first and quickly one pitch and one away as we start the Hernando fourth. It's the bottom of the order for the Leopards. Landon Carter coming up to the plate, and then Luke Puckett. 7, 8, and 9 guys. As Jacob Burnham gets this pitch into Landon Carter, and are we seeing the coming out party for Jacob Burnham, Judd?
And maybe he's really settled down.
The 0-1.
And think about it, really,
strike two.
First inning really wasn't his fault.
No, there was some balls with that high sky that were trouble for the Conk outfielders. They had four consecutive hits and scored four runs, but since then he has really gotten into a groove and also worked out a two big errors in that third inning as that pitch missed for a ball. Thrown 47 pitches through three innings. Is
See
that
ya.
Not a strike? Yes, yeah. It is. He'll strike him out. Strike him out looking. That's his seventh strikeout, Judd.
Yep.
As Jacob, the freshman who keeps growing and getting better and working into the fourth inning here today, picks up his seventh K. He hasn't walked anybody here yet. And he's looking for his second 1-2-3 inning of this game. And he gets Luke Puckett to chase that one low and outside. And I like that pitch, especially with a first pitch swinging team. Throw it way out of the strike zone. See if they'll chase it. He did, and he's in the hole 0-1. Much the same pitch, and this time Puckett lays off. Puckett, the victim of a strikeout back in the second inning. By the way, I want to say hi to everybody watching.
Uh-oh.
That ball is hit down the right field line, and that's going to drop in for a hit and get all the way to the wall. It'll be extra bases for Luke Puckett. He's thinking about a triple. Here comes the relay throw. Preston's got the throw there.
Yeah, he's out there.
And they got him by a mile.
Well, they hit the right relay guy right there, Preston Hurst. Great throw. Great throw from Haggard to Hurst and Hurst to Coon.
So score that 9-4-5 on the throwout. And what a play there. And you're absolutely right. That rocket arm of Hurst in there in plenty of time. Coon applies the tag, and that'll do it for the Leopards here in the top of the fourth. No runs on one hit. There were no Key West errors. Nobody left on base. We've played 3.5. It's still Hernando 4, Key West 2. It's Conk Baseball here on the Zone 97.7.
Leading off of your Conks, number 24, Trevor Zelch.
We move to the bottom of the fourth inning. Hernando leading Key West by the score of 4-2. Trevor Zelch is at the plate as Clay Oates has delivered two pitches while we've been away. One for a ball, one for a strike. So it's Zelch followed by Michael Alfonso and Jack Haggard. 5, 6, and 7 guys for our Conks. And Trevor asks for time as Oates had stepped off the rubber. Oates on to his fourth inning of work here. He's thrown 55 pitches coming into this inning. I think that's what I had there, or 53. What do you
have? I got
53. Pardon me. I can't even read my own writing. As that pitch, it misses ball two. So 53 pitches through those first three innings. He struck out 4. He's walked 2. Conks have got 3 hits off of him here. 2 aided by that high sky early in the ball game that helped get our 2 runs in the second inning. But here he falls behind Zelch, 3 balls and 1 strike. Trevor had a double into left field in his first at bat and scored a run. Zelch in the DH role here tonight. Waits this pitch and it's way low on the shoot tops. Ball 4, he's walked him.
Walk to Zelch brings up number 28.
So
Michael
that
Alfonso
is the third walk issued by Oates, and the Conks get the leadoff man aboard, and maybe that's it for Clay Oates now.
I got a feeling it may be.
Their skipper is coming out of the dugout right now.
He wants a sweep. I mean, he's not going to play around, I don't think.
Right. Let's see what he does here as he brings the entire infield in.
Now, there's no action in their pen, though.
Well, they did have action earlier. Like Key West, Hernando is a 4A school. They're in District 7.
Gonna leave him in.
Looks
I
like he's
right
gonna he's gonna leave him in there. Right now they have a 2-run lead, but might be a short leash after this. As he had,
well, if he comes out another time, he's got to pull.
He's got to take him. So it's a long meeting out on the hill, and now they get somebody warming up down in the pen just now. So the umpires need to go up and break this out, either make the change or
let's play ball.
So they break it up here, and they're going to leave him in right now. So let's see if the Conks get some damage done, and boy, we could use a big hit from Michael Alfonso right now.
Yep.
Michael, a victim of a strikeout back in the second inning. After being given up 16 hits and 10 runs last night, and then the Conks falling down quickly 4-0 in the top of the first, our boys showing a lot of fight here. It's a 2-run game, 4-2 game. Let's move Zelch around. They're going to try and lay down the bunt. And that's one thing that Ralphie's been wanting to do. And it's a good one. The pitcher bobbles it and then throws it away over at first base. Everybody's going to be safe. Trevor Zelch is going to move all the way down to third base. And that's something that Ralphie has been trying to get the guys to do. Lay down that sacrifice bunt and make them make a play. And that was a perfect bunt that time off the bat of Michael Alfonso. Trying to pick it up there on the third base side of the mound was the pitcher, Clay Oates, who then threw it wildly for an error.
Well, actually, Michael beat it out for a base hit, mm-hmm. and the throw went behind that right as Michael touched the base. That's how he gets the second. That's how I'm scoring it, is an E1 to second.
I'll go with you on that one as well. Let's
it was
give
a great bunt by Michael.
And runners at second and third. Nobody out for Jack Haggard, who worked out a walk. They got that tying run at second base. Get him home. Yep. Come on, Jackie. Here we go. Haggard looks at this pitch high, ball one.
Now, 3 of the 4 infielders are up. The shortstop is the only one that's playing back at normal depth. Now the second baseman's starting to drop back. Corners are up.
Count is 1-0 to Jack Haggard. Haggard will take a hack of this one and pop it up on the infield behind the mound. Standing on that KW and blazing behind the mound, and in between second base and the mound is the second baseman, Gabe Trafalski. He waits for it to come down, and he makes the grab. So there's one away here on the pop-up by Haggard. That'll bring up Nate Barroso. Can Nate do it again? He had a nice RBI single in his last at-bat. And he comes up to the plate with runners at second and third. Zelch at third, Alfonso at second.
Barroso.
Here we go, Nate. For first pitch to Barroso is a little bit low, ball one. But Fernando, we told you last night, it's one of the oldest schools, high schools in the country. It's been in operation since 1889. Long storied sports history. Outstanding year this year.
Think about this one. Yeah. How many times have they rebuilt that high school?
Well, you would think probably in 1889 it was probably a log cabin or
right?
something like that. Yeah. The 2-0 outside ball three. But in all those years, only one state championship in baseball. That came in 1967. I always think that's remarkable, too, Judd, when you look at how many titles we've won. 11 in baseball.
Yep.
It really is remarkable if you stop and think about it. Taking it all the way is Barroso, and that gets in there for a strike. It's so hard just to win one. But to have that many, 11.
And be a public school.
And
that's
be a public school? Yeah, remarkable. The 3-1 swung on and lifted into right field. That's going to be deep enough to score at least Zelch from third. He tags up as Fisher makes the grab. The throw comes home. Tagging up at second and moving to third is Michael Alfonso. And just like that, Judd, it's a one-run ball game. It's now a 4-3 game.
Yep, Barroso does what he's supposed to do. Get the ball out of the infield. And he does it. He hits a deep enough fly ball for a sacrifice fly and an RBI.
And that's his second RBI of this ball game for Barroso, who now has five of them. Here's Kai Smith. He picked up an RBI when he walked with the bases loaded back in the second inning. So Oates, like he has throughout the game, works out of the stretch and delivers this one well inside ball one. Historically, between these two teams, this series got underway back, the first time we met was back in 2016. Ooh, that pitch almost hits him. Spins him off the plate. Ball two. And the Conks lead the all-time series 3-2. Last time they were here in 2019, we split the two games. The first time they came here in 16, we won both of them. They took the first game of the series last night. As that pitch misses again, ball three. Top of the order, Wyatt Kuhn on deck. Here's the 3-0. That's ball four. A little low. And he walked him. Second walk he's issued this inning. Now four in the game. And Conks have runners on the corners, and it's back to the top of the order, and that's going to do it for Clay Oates. Their skipper's going to head out to the mound and his second visit this inning, and that will do it for the tall righty here as Conks will chase him in the fourth inning. So we're going to get our first pitching change of the ball game, which will be delivered, of course, by Domino's Pizza. Hey, Domino's didn't stop at pizza, and you don't have to either. Give Dale and his wonderful crew a call at 305-296-7795 for pickup or delivery. Hey, get the door. It's Domino's Pizza. While the new pitcher for the Leopards comes in to warm up, we'll take a 90-second break. We're here in the fourth inning. Conks have runners on the corners and now trail by the score of 4-3. Back after this here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WABK. let's see here. Just looking up NCAA scores right now. And as we are in the fourth inning, there you go, Judd. Baylor won over Houston 78-59. So Baylor moves into the championship game on Monday in the NCAA tournament. And coming up should just be about getting underway. Yep. UCLA and Gonzaga, so Baylor has won. All right, the Conks have chased
14,
the Leopards starter, Clay Oates, here in the fourth. So Hernando goes to the pen, and they bring in a senior righty, Trenton Manor, to face Wyatt Kuhn as the Conks are back to the top of the order. Two outs, but Key West has runners on the corners. Kuhn takes a hack at the first offering from Manor and fouls it back to the backstop for strike one. Book not closed yet on Clay Oates, who went 3 2/3 innings. His runners on the base paths, if they score, would be charged to him. Gave up four hits. He struck out four and walked four. And Kuhn swings at the second pitch and again fouls it out of play for strike two. We're in the bottom of the fourth inning. Conks trailed 4-0 after the top of the first inning, but have now closed the lead to just one. It's a 4-3 game. Tying runs over at third in the body of Michael Alfonso right now. And are they gonna call a balk or not? No. Now they're gonna have in a pickle over there at first, Kai Smith, and now they'll throw home as he's trying to get back to third base is Michael Alfonso. As first you heard everybody screaming a balk call as Kai Smith took off. He'll swipe the second base bag, and he gets himself in a pickle. And then while he's in the pickle, Alfonso takes off. They throw to home, but then
came from the pitcher who threw it too soon back to first base. He should have kept running at the runner.
So both runners, so the Conks put some motion out there, and both runners in scoring position. Count, though, no balls and two strikes to Wyatt Kuhn. Pitch on its way. Oh, fastball on the outside portion of the plate. He'll strike him out looking. So Manor comes in and gets him out of a mess here in the fourth inning as he is able to strike out Wyatt Kuhn, and that'll do it for the Conks. But Key West is able to pick up a run on one hit. There was one error, and Key West will leave two men out on the base paths. We played 3.5, or excuse me, we got four of the books now.
Yeah,
we'll head to the fifth. Hernando 4, Key West 3, back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WADK. Conk baseball here on The Zone, 97.7 WABK Sports Radio for the Florida Keys. On to the fifth we go. The fifth inning of every Conk baseball game here on The Zone is brought to you by First State Bank of the Florida Keys. 11 locations Keys wide, the last and only locally owned bank in the Keys. Top of the fifth we are, and Hernando now leading 4-3 as back out on the hill for his fifth inning of work.
is Jacob Burnham. He's dealing with the top of the order. In the first two pitches, he gets past Dylan Dufilly, who's in the hole. No balls and two strikes. Their shortstop
see ya.
Is oh, no, they don't bring him up. That pitch is a little low.
Ooh,
apparently.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I was with you on that one, Judd.
I thought that was a little knee high on the corner, but I guess it was a little bit low.
Good crowd on hand here, and Conk fans didn't like the call either. So it's the top of the order that Burnham's got to deal with here in their half of the fifth. And their leadoff man continues to swing the hot bat and takes this 1-2 pitch and rips it into left field. His second hit of the game. He's 2-for-3. He got him going back in the first inning with the leadoff triple.
Yeah, this is a big inning for Burnham right here because we are at the top of the order again.
Yeah, and got to deal with these big-time hitters that they got here. They got another one coming up to the plate, their catcher, Dylan Schotzel, who's been on base twice today.
And Dufilly likes to run, so we got to be careful of that, too.
Keep an eye on him as that pitch is a little low, ball one. Schotzel had an RBI double and scored in the first inning. Reached on an error in the third, but got stranded over at the third base bag. Burnham with the pitch in there for a strike. And here, Burnham as a lefty. He's looking right at Dufilly. He's got a modest lead right now over at first base. Holding him on is Alfonso. There he goes. The pitch is in there for a strike. Throw down to second.
Yes.
In time. Yes, sir. How about that, Daniel Varela? Attaboy. As he guns down to Philly, and there's one away.
Great throw by Daniel.
I mean, that was on the money. And a nice tag by Hurst as well. Big swing and miss, and he'll strike him out. There we go. Let's get excited, Conk fans. Not quite the strike him out, throw him out, but as close as you can get there, Judd.
We'll take it.
One pitch later. We'll take it. So a tremendous throw there by Daniel Varela to gun down the speedy Dufilly. And then Schotzel strikes out. That's the eighth K of the game for the freshman, Burnham. As this pitch is low, ball one. Jacob making his fifth start of the year for Key West. Again, just a youngster, a freshman. This ball is fisted up in the air right to the second baseman.
Yes, we'll take a 1-2-3.
That's Kai Smith, and it ends up being a 1-2-3 inning on the pop-up to second. Wow. Outstanding work by the Conks here at the top of the fifth. For Hernando, no runs on one hit. There were no errors, and nobody was left. We're in the middle of the First State Bank of the Florida Keys fifth inning. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Still Hernando 4, Key West 3. Back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WAVK. All right, let's go Conks here as we head to the bottom of the fifth. Let's get some runs here. Key West trailing Hernando only by one. Hernando leads 4-3 as we move to the bottom of the First State Bank of the Florida Keys fifth inning. Landon Lowe will lead things off, and he shows bunt and almost gets hit in the face and has to drop down to the turf as he pulls the bat back for ball one. It's low, followed by Preston Hurst, and then Daniel Varela. 2, 3, and 4 guys for the Conks in our half of the fifth. Back in is Trenton Manor on the hill, came in relief of Clay Oates. Ball was swung on and fouled back to the backstop. Oates went the first 3 2/3. Conks were able to scratch out 3 runs off of him. Gave up 4 hits. He struck out 4. He walked 4. He threw 70 pitches. He left the game. Conks had runners at second and third. That pitch misses inside, ball 2, and they brought Manor in, and he was able to strike out Wyatt Kuhn to get out of that inning. So this is just the second batter that he's faced. Low 0-2 today. Landon didn't have any luck against Oates. See if he does a little better here with Manor, and he's ahead in the count now. 3 balls and 1 strike.
Yep, need a base runner.
Here's the 3-1. Swung on, hit hard, past the diving second baseman into right field. A mistake made there initially by Gabe Tafowski as he went to his right, but the ball was to his left. He tried to recover, dove for it, couldn't get to it, and that's a hit for Landon Lowe, the
exactly.
Hot hitting Lowe.
Yep. He was able to get that one past him, and, you know, even if he would have come up with that,
I don't think they get him.
No. Preston Hurst, number 10.
Here we go, Preston. Jack Niles working the up in the booth there tonight is the stadium announcer.
Good.
They'll fire over to the first base bag. He sounds good. Runner back in safely over at first is Landon Lowe. It was Preston, who's 0-2 today. He's popped up twice to the shortstop, so he's due. Let's go, Preston. Take that pitch in there for a strike. No balls and one strike. Conks settling in for a homestand here. After Hernando, next weekend, next Friday and Saturday. Coming from the West Coast over from Naples, Baron Collier will be in town for 2 games. Yeah. Another team we've had a built a good relationship with. And so far, so good, right, Judd?
As far as I know.
Them coming? Yep. This pitch sails high, ball 1 to Preston. So, yep, Baron Collier next Friday and Saturday. Those are the 2 games the Conks have next week. There's no games during the weekdays next week, so just 2 next weekend. But again, we'll be home. That'll be nice. The 1-1. Big swing and a miss. Strike 2 for all that's been, you know, happening on the road for us this year, Judd, and all the road games here at home. We haven't really taken advantage of the time we've been at home, just 1-4 so far this year at the Rex. The 1-2. That sails high, ball 2.
Yep, well, hopefully we'll turn around this month.
Yep, that's what we're hoping for. All games except for 1 for the regular season games will be here at the Rex. 7 of the 8 games. Again, they'll throw over to first base and the runner back in safely. We told you last night that it is now official where the district tournament will be. The District 16 4A tournament will be hosted by Miami Springs. There goes the runner. The ball is swung on and popped up at home plate. Schatzel calls everybody off in foul territory and then makes the grab, falls down. Foul territory up the first baseline. Falls down, makes the catch, and then as he's on the ground, tries to double up the runner who had took off over at first base, and he throws it from his belly there, but not in time over there. So Hurst pops up to the catcher. Preston just getting under it a bit tonight, Judd.
Yep, and but I'll tell you, thankful that Schwartzel fell down because a good throw to first would have probably gotten that.
Yeah. The Lowe was able to get back there. All right, here's Daniel Varela. He's 1-2. Daniel looks at that one in there for a strike. Daniel had a single and scored back in the second inning. Moving Daniel up to that cleanup spot. He has had a pension this year for coming up with big hits. Use another one here. Take a hack and foul this one out of play. Conks trying to come back. The Leopards picked up where they left off last night and got
four runs on four hits in the first inning. Since then, Key West has done all the scoring. Got within one. It's a 4-3 game. Tying run over at first with one away. Pitch is well outside. Daniel doesn't chase, and the count at 1-2. Grillo with that big wide stance from the right-hand side. Looks at this one, sail low again. And the count now at 2-2. Having a little Pepsi game break right now, Judd. That's refreshing. Hey, Pepsi, grab one today. Official soft drink of your Key West Conks. Two balls, two strikes here to Varela.
Oh,
hey, that pitch is inside, ball three. That was close.
Yeah.
As Manor took something off of that one. But Daniel gets the call. So the count is now full, three balls and two strikes. Skipper pacing out in front of the Conk dugout. Ralph Enriquez looking for a big hit here. Three balls, two strikes to Varela. He'll have to wait as they go back to first yet again. And they're keeping a close eye on Landon over there.
I like it because the more you throw over to first, the more you're not concentrating on the glove at the plate.
Three balls, two strikes. There he goes. The pitch is swung on, and that one is hit deep down the left field line. That is going to drop in for a hit off the base of the wall, and Varela comes up with another big hit, rounding the third base bag. Coming home to tie up the ball game is Landon Lowe on the RBI double off the bat of Daniel Varela. Hey, hey!
Varela took that fastball, drilled it to the 305 sign right there, easily scoring Landon, who took off on the hit and run.
Attaboy, Daniel. It's now a 4-4 ball game. The Conks have come all the way back. Second
double
hit this
Varela
inning for Key West.
For
Varela, he picks up another RBI
number
here.
24.
Daniel now has 11
courtesy
on the year.
We got a pinch runner in.
That Rady has come in to run for Varela at second base, so get a little bit more speed out there for Trevor Zelch, who's been on board twice today. Doubled and scored in the second, worked out a walk, and scored in the fourth. And that's for the second time in two nights, Judd, Varela hit it off the bottom of the fence.
Yep.
Did that last night in center field, and this last at bat into left as that pitch is in there for a strike. By the way, Conks do get one over the fence. That is a Tavern in Town home run dinger. We had the first person that can get to Judd and myself up here at the Todd Swafford Broadcast Pavilion. Check swing on a high fastball up by his face. He was just protecting himself. And it goes off the bat and right back to the pitcher, picked up by Manor, and Zelch is out. And that's just one of those, Judd, where you're almost like protecting yourself.
You are.
As that ball is coming up at his face.
But it does move the runner to third base.
So Andon Rady, who's running for Varela, just 90 feet away here. And if Michael Alfonso can come up with a hit here, the Conks will have a lead for the first time in this series. Alfonso checks himself on the big breaking ball, and it's in there for a strike one. So, yeah, if a Conks hit a home run, that's Tavern in Town, home run dinger. Come up and see us. First person that gets to us, $50 gift certificate at Tavern in Town. Conks place for dinner. The 0-1. Just a bit outside, and the count at one ball and one strike. For Michael, he's one for two today, laid down a beautiful bunt single back in the fourth inning where he was actually sacrificing himself, but he got on board with a single in an errant throw after he got that base hit. Conks were able to get a run there in the fourth after that. His pitch is low, ball two. His other at bat, he struck out back in the second. He's got the count in his favor, two balls and one strike. Righty, Trenton Manor comes home. Ball is swung on and lifted out of play beyond the main. Oh, no, it comes back with the wind and lands in the main grandstand directly behind home plate for strike two. Let's take the lead here.
Two balls and two strikes. The pitch. Oh, did that hit him?
Yeah.
Oh, he somehow gets out of the way of that breaking ball. And the way that Alfonso was grimacing, I thought he got plunked a little bit there, but I guess it broke away from him as he had to back off of the plate. So it misses for ball three. Count runs full, 3-2. They'll walk him high, ball four. That's the 19th time that Alfonso has been issued a free pass with a walk. So now runners on the corners for Key West for Jack Haggard.
All right, Jack, here you go. You've done it before, let's do it again. You've come through with the clutch hit with the runner in scoring position to give us a lead.
Time out on the field right now. Haggard will have to wait. Haggard going with the old school baseball look as he's got the pants pulled up to his knees and he's showing his red leggings. As he comes to the plate, he's got Andon Rady running for Daniel Varela over at third. Michael Alfonso is at first. Conks have tied the game up here in the bottom of the fifth. It's a 4-4 game, looking to take the lead. Haggard awaits the pitch and it's outside, ball one. Haggard has had a couple of big hits this year. He's only a sophomore, getting the opportunity again here tonight to play right field. He had to deal with that crazy sky early in the ball game. All the outfielders struggled with that on both teams. It was bad tonight. The 1-1. This ball is swung on in the hole at short. Slow roller. Shortstop will go to second. He's pretty dependable over there for Hernando, Dylan DeFilly, and he'll ground out, score at 6-4 on the out, and the inning will come to a close, but the Conks are able to tie it up. They pick up a run on two hits. There were no errors, and two men left out there running off the base paths. So that'll do it for the First State Bank of the Florida Keys fifth inning. We'll head to the sixth. New ball game as we're tied at 4 apiece. We're back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WABK. It's Conk Baseball here on The Zone, 97.7 WAVK. On to the top of the sixth we go. Key West and Hernando all tied at 4. Out for his sixth inning of work is Jacob Burnham. He's thrown two pitches to Nick Talpa. One for a ball, one for a strike. So he's dealing with the 4, 5, and 6 guys here as we get the sixth inning underway. He'll take a hack at this one, chop a foul. 4 strike 2, Nick Talpa. Been on base twice today, had an RBI triple and scored back in the first inning, reached on an error in the third. For Jacob Burnham, this is his longest outing of the year. He's through 5 innings here tonight. This pitch is high, ball 2. And what you like, Judd, the pitch count is extremely low, only 64. He struck out 8. He's walked nobody here today. And you have to love the way that the kid hung in after that tough
there
start.
There you go. See ya, baby.
In the first inning. Big swing and a miss. He'll strike him out. Put it on the board. That's the ninth strikeout of the game. But what I was saying, Judd, before the strikeout is, man, he gives up four hits in a row, two of them triples. They score four runs to start the game.
Yeah.
But the kid just hung tough. He worked through two big errors in the third inning, and this is one heck of an impressive performance by the freshman.
Yeah, he's done a great job tonight. Like you said, you know, when you're going into the sixth inning, only 64 pitches, that's, you know, a little over 10 an inning. That's great.
First pitch to Riley Fisher, missed for a ball. The second one is also low, ball two. Riley Fisher, the right fielder for the Leopards. 0 for 2, but did pick up an RBI on a fielder's choice way back in the first inning. Slow roller over toward the second base bag.
I think it hit the bag.
Did that hit the bag?
I think the ball hit the bag, and that's why Preston was unable to come up with it cleanly.
Now, let's see what they say up in the scoreboard.
Preston, I'm giving it a base hit.
Preston was going over to pick it up, and then it took a weird hop. And I think, you know, Judd, I think it did hit the bag. Now they're ruling it an error.
Okay.
They put an error up there.
I think it hit the bag. Russ, if you're watching, what do you see?
I couldn't tell as he slid down to go get it, and a slow roller back up the middle either hit the bag, but their official scorer is giving it an error here in six. So they got a runner on with one away here, regardless, as Riley Fisher's over at first. Here's Gabe Trafalski. First pitch, Trafalski in there for a strike. He's 0 for 2 today, struck out both times. Quick toss over the bag, and the wind is picking up again.
Yeah, starting to whip.
And, I mean, it is just like last night. It is blowing extremely hard from right to left. They'll fire over to the bag again. Am I going to have to deal with this wind on the golf course tomorrow?
Oh, absolutely. Going to be crazy.
Keep it low. Bring the low irons. The 0-1. He's going to lay down the sacrifice bunt back to the pitcher. Gosh darn it.
There's an eagle.
Burnham goes to pick it up and then kind of loses his footing and drops the ball. That'll be an error. Back-to-back errors. And they get a couple of guys on board here. And quickly coming out of the dugout to slow things down is Ralph Enriquez Jr. He's done a tremendous job working with these pitchers and catchers, and right there by his dad's side. He's a great player here at Key West High School, part of the 05 state championship team. From the camera view, it definitely looks like it hits the bag. Okay, well.
Thanks, Russ.
Okay. That's from the TV, but we'll go right now with the scores. Russ Milliken?
Yep.
Hey, Russ.
Watching.
Did he save us any cookies?
No, he ate them all. He's on his second batch already.
He made us cookies last night, but he ate them all. Right. Here's Stevens Hart. He'll look at this pitch, low ball one. Now, here's what the doctor writing the prescription right now, Judd. How about a double play?
Yes, we could use one right now.
One ball. No strikes. The Hart, who's 0 for 2. Big swing and a miss. For strike one. Got to thank George Riaseco as well.
Yep, George came down
and Judd surprised me this morning. Woke me up this morning, but it was worth waking me up for. This pitch is outside. Ball two, and George had brought these cinnamon rolls from
the Knoxbury Farm
folks.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
Wow.
Were they good?
It was worth waking up for.
Yeah.
Thank you, George. Judd actually shared. The 2-1. Swung on and hit in the hole between first and second. That's going to get into right field. Will they send Fisher? They do. Here comes the throw home. Not going to be in time with the throw coming home. Trafalski will take the third base bag. It'll be an RBI single off the bat of Stevens Hart. And Hernando comes right back here, takes advantage of the two errors, and retakes the lead. It's a 5-4 game.
Yep, took the fastball on the outside portion of the plate, drove it past Michael Alfonso. Hager comes up with it and has no play at the plate.
All right, so they're back in the lead here. As Landon Carter awaits, his time is on the field. Are they bringing in a
pinch runner?
They're bringing in a runner for
number
the
44.
Third baseman.
Yep.
Is that number 44?
Yep.
Are you sure it was 44?
I believe so.
I have a 44 here. Let me see.
Thank you, 44.
It is 44? Let's see if I can find it. I don't have it.
Okay. It's number 44.
Have a runner in for Hart. The show bunt, and it looks like they wanted to do a suicide squeeze there as coming way down the line was Trefowski, but if you do that, that's interesting with a lefty who showed bunt then pulled the bat back for ball one. Because, I mean, the catcher has an unobstructed view at the runner over at third base. They'll fire over to first and the runner back in safely. So runners on the corners. There's one away here. Landon Carter at the plate. He's 0 for 2. He's going to lay down the bunt. It's a good one. It's fielded by the third baseman, Wyatt Goon, and he threw it away. And Michael Alfonso is hurt as the ball has gone off of his glove, and he's wrenched his arm as he was reaching for it. He collides with the runner. Scoring is Trefowski. It'll be an error. Third error of this inning on the bunt. And down at third base is Hart. So score that E5, and right now all the concern right now is for Michael Alfonso as he was reaching for the ball. Him and Carter kind of collided at the same time because the throw was up the line. And good news here as Alfonso seems to be able to shake this off, and he's staying in the ballgame. So three errors this inning for Key West after the Conks fought all the way back. And that's going to do it for Jacob Burnham, who pitched his heart out here today. Coming out party for the young freshman.
Big hand for Jacob Burnham.
Outstanding work for him as he will head to the dugout and get high fives all around from his teammates. So Jacob's night is done. The Conks will go to the pen here, and we'll have another pitching change being delivered by Domino's Pizza. Domino's didn't stop at pizza, and you don't have to either. Give Domino's a call at 305-296-7795 for pickup or delivery. Get the door. It's Domino's Pizza. While the new Conk pitcher warms up, we'll take a 90-second break. As Hernando has struck for two more here in the top of the sixth. They lead 6-4. We're back after this here on your home of the Conks, the Zone, 97.7. Well, the Leopards have retaken the lead here in the top of the sixth. They now lead 6-4. Conks committing three errors here in the sixth. Jacob Burnham's night on the mound is done. Marlon Takovich is going to come in now and try and get out of this mess as they've got runners at second and third. And they'll have a new hitter at the plate. It's Carlos Gonzalez.
is coming in to hit. He's hitting in the nine hole where Luke Puckett was. He shows bunt, and it's a good one. Fielded by Takovich. They'll come home, and they got him. They tried the squeeze. They had the speedy runner coming down the third baseline with a head first slide. Good job by Takovich. Nice tag there by Daniel Varela, and there's two away.
Yep, great play right there. All right, Takovich coming right off the mound, being able to make the scoop, and good tag by Varela.
And score 1-2 on the putout. Moving down to third base is Landon Carter, and Gonzalez over at first. So they went small ball here, Judd.
They did.
It worked the first time. This time, Conks are able to get that lead runner at the plate, keep the game right now at a 6-4 game. Back to the top of the order, and their dangerous leadoff man, Dylan Dufilly. Dufilly takes the off-speed pitch from Takovich in there for a strike. Book still not quite closed on Jacob Burnham, who went 5 1/3 innings. That runner at third base would go on his line if he's able to score. That pitch is in there for strike two. So Takovich coming in. Marlin 0-4 on the year with an ERA of 7.22 and 10 2/3 innings of work. He's quickly ahead here, 0-2. Ball was swung on and fouled back into the netting. The count remains at no balls and two strikes. Marlin's given up 14 hits, 16 runs, 11 have been earned. 12 base on balls, 11 Ks, and he's hit a batter. The 0-2, off speed, bottom drops out. The Philly lays off, ball one. Landon Carter is over at third. Carlos Gonzalez is at first.
That's see ya, baby.
A good looking pitch. Off speed, breaking ball, strike him out looking. So Takovich comes in and gets out of the mess, but Hernando able to tack on two runs with one hit, helped out by three Key West errors, and they left two men out on the base paths. We'll head to the bottom of the sixth. Conks got more work to do as we trail 6-4. Back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WAVK. Conks will need to come back again. They've done it once. Can we do it twice? Key West now trailing Hernando by the score of 6-4 as we move to the bottom of the sixth inning. It'll be our 8-9 guys, Nate Barroso, followed by Kai Smith. And back to the top of the order, Wyatt Kuhn. Back out on the hill as Trenton Manor came into the game in the fourth inning. And he delivers this fastball, and it misses ball one. So Barroso's had a good day. Officially 1-for-1, had an RBI single in the second, picked up an RBI in the fourth on a sac fly. So a two RBI day for Barroso. As he looks at this one low and outside, ball two. Two balls, no strikes here. And that one will get in there for a strike. Conks fell down early in this game, right at the start of the game, 4-0 in the top of the first inning, then fought their way back, tied it up. But then there in the top of the sixth. They're able to scratch out two runs and helped out by three errors by Key West. Big swing and a miss. Strike two. Two balls, two strikes to Nate Barroso. Look at this one, low and outside. Ball three.
Well, it takes base runners. Anyway, we
gotta
get
them on. Let's get them on.
Get them on. We've made things happen.
Yeah. Right in this ball game. Here's the 3-2. And that's low, ball four, right? Yes, yep. It is. Okay.
Walk to Barroso.
So Barroso works out
three.
A walk.
Kai Smith.
Second walk
three.
Issued by Manor. Excuse me. And yes, that's his second walk. And sixth time Conks have got a walk here today. So we get the leadoff man aboard for Kai Smith. Speaking of walks, he's come to the plate twice and he's walked both times. His first walk in the second inning happened with the bases loaded. He picked up an RBI. He's going to try and lay down the bunt here, but bunts it off the plate and bounces over the catcher's head and rolls back to the backstop for strike one. What a job, though, tonight, Judd, by Jacob Burnham. I mean, boy, that kid gave you all he had here tonight. And if there weren't those three errors there in the sixth inning, he'd still be in this ball game. But he's kept his team in the game. Now can the Conks come back again? Pitch is outside for a ball. They'll fire down to first base. The catcher does. And not in time to pick off Barroso. So the count at 1-1. Here to Kai Smith. Takes a long look at his third base coach, Ralph Enriquez Jr. You know, looking at Ralphie there, and when he was out on the mound, mentioning that, you know, he's part of that 05 state championship team, Judd. That was 16 years ago now. Ooh, that fastball comes inside. He's got a drop to the deck, but the ball hits the bat as he was showing bunt, as he was going down like limbo, going under a limbo pole, and a break for Manor. This will pick up strike two there. But that was 16 years ago, last time the Conks won a state championship. Where is that time gone?
You right? Thinking the same thing, Rick.
The 1-2. Big breaking ball bounces in front of the plate. And the count at 2-2. My son, Tony Lopez, was on that team. He was the left fielder, and he's now a homicide detective and got two grandkids. Where is his time gone?
You're getting older, Lopez.
God. The 2-2. Swing and a miss. He'll strike him out. Second strikeout there for Manor. Sixth time a Conk has gone down via the K. Back to the top of the order, here's Wyatt Kuhn. Kuhn 0 for 3. In his second at bat, he hit into a double play, and that was about as good a double play turn that you'll ever see. It was an amazing play by their shortstop to Philly as that pitch gets in there for a strike. Bouncer, it looked like it was getting into center field. He has a full extension dive behind the bag, grabs it, and then just flips it, doesn't even grab it with his hand, flips it out of his glove to the second baseman, Trafalski, and then check swing here by Kuhn.
Oh, well.
Did he hit it? Was it fouled, or it's off the catcher, and it rolls over to the on-deck circle, and running down to second base is Nate Barroso.
We don't know. I don't.
Was it fouled or not? Is it check swing?
I guess.
Now the home plate umpire is asking, he needs some help from the infield umpire.
Yeah, send him back.
You're sending him back. I guess the ball went off the bat there.
Yeah.
And it's strike two. No balls and two strikes to Wyatt Kuhn. Here's the 0-2. Swung on and lifted into center field. Hey, that's trouble. That could drop, and it does. As Landon Carter was playing way back there, could not come in to make the grab, and it drops in for a hit for Wyatt Kuhn. Attaboy. Tying run is over at first base.
Yep. And you're exactly right, Rick. The center fielder was playing so deep, and they just didn't have a chance.
Seventh hit of the game for Key West. Here's Landon Lowe. He got us going in the fifth inning. He singled and
scored a run that, at that time, tied up the ball game. So Landon digs in there and rips this one foul. Good thing that netting is right there, Judd, or that would have come right into the booth here.
Yeah, we'd have had that.
I was ready.
I saw it. Yeah.
Landon is 1-for-3 today. He's got runners at first and second with one away here. Honks trying to come right back here in our half of the sixth. Now Manor's going to step off the rubber. Now here we go. He'll work out of the stretch with runners at first and second. Big breaking ball. Doesn't break enough and misses ball one. Inside to the righty. Landon low. Guy you want at the plate right now. He has been hot. Let's keep it hot, Landon. And he rips this one. That's going to get over the second baseman's head. Drop into the outfield. They're going to wave Barroso around. He's going to be able to come home and score. It's an RBI single off the bat of Landon Lowe. It's now a 6-5 game. These conks just keep coming.
Landon takes that fastball, just hits it over the second baseman's head. Good job. Barroso on his wheels, comes home, scores easily. Runners at first and second, still one out.
Number 10, Preston.
Oh, he's hot, Judd, and continues his hot hitting. Came into today batting 368. Two more hits here. Picks up another RBI. That was his team-leading 16th RBI. Here's Preston Hurst. He's due here today. He's popped up three times, and now he lifts this one into shallow center field. Long run coming in is Landon Carter, but it hangs up long enough for him to get underneath it and make the grab. And that's the fourth time tonight that Preston has just been underneath it a bit and pops it up.
Yeah, I'm just real surprised how deep their center fielder is playing.
They had a long way to go, but that time it hung up long enough for Carter to get to it. So now two away here for Daniel Varela. Has he got another hit in that bat? He's 2-for-3. Had an RBI double in his last at bat in the fifth. Had a single and scored in the second. It moved him up to the cleanup spot. And he'll take that pitch in there for strike one. No balls and one strike. Big breaking ball swung on and lifted high into left field. Playable out there, though, for the left fielder, Luke Puckett, who makes the grab, and the inning will come to a close. Well, the Conks get a little closer here as we're able to pick up one run on two hits. There are no errors, and we left two men out on the base paths. We'll head to the seventh. It's now Hernando 6, Key West 5. thezone977.com. We've got a lot of cool new features there, including for archiving the Conk baseball games that you hear here on The Zone. So you can go back and listen to them. Just go to the website. You can find it there. Also go to the Conk page, Conk baseball page, and get all the historical stats as well. You'll find it all on our website, thezone977.com. Top of the seventh, Takovich delivers the first pitch to Dylan Schatzel. It's low, ball one. The 1-0 is a little bit low again, ball two. Tack came into the ball game in the sixth inning after the Conks had committed three errors behind Jacob Burnham and had to make the move there. And Tack did a good job and got out of a potentially really big mess. And that pitch is outside, ball three. Here's the final line score for Burnham. 5 1/3 innings, 6 runs, 4 were earned on 7 hits. He struck out 9. He walked nobody tonight. That pitch is in there for a strike, and because the home plate umpire is a long delayed call, Schatzel thought he worked out the walk. And now he's got a word for the home plate umpire, and he just needs to put the gloves back on and get back in there. And he will. And the count at 3-1. But you got to wait a minute or so. This ball is swung on, and he rips it. But a great play by Preston Hurst. Does he have a trampoline out there? As he got so high, a full vertical leap. What is his vertical leap, Judd? As he just robs Schatzel of a hit.
Yep, good job by Preston. Went right up. Timed
it.
That's
a great
perfectly.
Catch.
Yep, timed it perfectly.
He just robbed him of a hit there. It's almost like he was on a trampoline and bounced up in the air and pulled that one down. Oh, he's got some athletic ability, that young man. And he showed it right there. One down as Anthony Taupo will come to the plate. He's 1-for-3. It's one hit. That was back in the first inning, an RBI single. And that pitch gets in there for a strike. No balls and one strike. Talpa's got the big wide stance and takes a hack. Where's the number 99? Fouls it away. He's quickly in the hole. 0-2. No balls, two strikes. Pitch on its way. One in the dirt. Into the carpet. Some habits you just can't get rid of.
Looks like dirt.
It does. So beautiful, this turf field that we have here now, the turfed infield. The grass, we still have grass in the outfield here. The 1-2, low again, ball two. Two balls, two strikes here. To Anthony Taupo. Hernando making the long trip down from Brooksville. Trying to complete the sweep here. The Conks are battling hard here tonight. Key West trailing by just a run. You got to keep it that way. Count remains 2-2. Tack out of the full windup, comes home. Fastball swung on. Hit back up the middle, fielded there by the Conk second baseman. That's Guy Smith. Comes in, makes a nice play, fires over to first, and there's two down.
Good job by Kai right there.
Yep.
I wasn't sure if that ball actually picked Takovich's glove.
You know, it may have, Judd, and may have taken a little turn back closer to our second baseman to go be able to get it.
Yeah, because I'm scoring it 1-4-3.
Okay.
I think it actually hit off his glove a little bit.
Here's the other Taupo, Nick, and he gets plunked on the top of his lead shoulder. And that's the first hit batter of the ball game. And that's not what Takovich wants to do here
with
two quick outs and put a runner on the bases. But he hits him here. And that has been a problem for the Conk pitching staff. We've hit a lot of guys. That's the 26th time we've hit a batter. Second time that Takovich has hit one. Big swing and a miss by the lefty, Riley Fisher, strike one. There are two away here. Here's the 0-1. Swung on, and this ball is hit deep straightaway center field, going way back there, and looking up is Landon Lowe, and it's a two-run homer off the bat of Riley Fisher, and gives him a couple of extra insurance runs. It's now an 8-5 ball game. And then as Fisher comes across the plate, he's mobbed by his teammates. And that's a big hit right there, a two-run shot.
Yeah, that's a bomber.
So that hit batter extends the inning, and then Fisher comes through with the two-run homer. That's his third RBI of the ball game. And that was a big one, and that gives him a couple of extra insurance runs. And the lead is now 3 for Hernando. Here's Gabe Tefowski. He's 0 for 3 today. Did reach on an error in the sixth and scored. He'll take that one in there for a strike. No balls, one strike. Swung on and went off his foot there as a slow roller down the third baseline and goes foul for strike two. Well, the inning started off with two quick outs, highlighted by that great catch by Preston Hurst, but then the hit batter extended the inning and then the two-run home by Fisher. The 0-2, wild, way high. As Bob Uecker would say, just a bit high. Off the middle portion of the netting behind home plate. Tack let that one fly. The 1-2. And low ball two. 2-2. Here's the 2-2. Ball is swung on, hit into right field. Jack Haggard going back, and he still going back and camps underneath it. It makes a nice catch out there, and the inning will come to a close, but not before the Leopards are able to tack on two big insurance runs on one hit. The one hit, the two-run homer off the bat from Riley Fisher. There were no errors and nobody left on base. We'll head to the bottom of the seventh. It's now Hernando 8, Key West 5. Last chance for your Conks. Don't go away. We're back in 90 seconds. Let's see if the Conks have a seventh inning rally. We're trailing by 3. Hernando leads 8-5. It'll be our 5, 6, and 7 guys. Trevor Zelch, Michael Alfonso, and Jack Haggard all due to bat. Still out there on the hill for the Leopards is Trenton Manor.
He came in relief back in the fourth inning. He is the pitcher of record right now for the Leopards. And he's trying to not only pick up the win, but close it out and see if he can help Hernando to the sweep of this two-game set. Delivers that pitch to Zelch in there for a strike. They do have some action going on down in their pen right now. The Conks got three outs to work with, and we trail by three. The 0-1 to Zelch. It's a bit high, ball one. Trevor's been on base a couple of times today. He's 1-for-2, doubled and scored in the second, worked out a walk and scored in the fourth, grounded back to the pitcher on a check swing in his other at-bat in the fifth. That pitch will miss, ball two.
Yeah. It all starts with the base runners.
Got to get somebody on. Got to get them on. The 2-1. Swung on and popped up down the left field line. That is a tough play. And that's going to drop in for a hit for Trevor Zelch. Nobody could get to that one. A Texas leaguer in no man's land out there in shallow left field. Maybe the third baseman could get to it, but a very difficult play for Stevens Hart. And that'll drop in for the ninth hit of the game for Key West and the second for Zelch. So there we go. Let's take advantage of that. Let's keep it rolling. Here's Michael Alfonso. We had a scary moment with Michael earlier in the game playing first on a reaching up the line to try and grab a throw to him at first base, and he collided with the runner, and he's okay. He'll take that pitch in there for a strike. At the plate today, Michael is 1-for-2. It's one hit, a bunt single back in the fourth. Did work out a walk in the fifth. Slow breaking ball swung on, popped up to the third baseman. Standing right by the bag, then goes into foul territory. That's Stevens Hart, and he'll make the grab, and there's one down. So Hart hangs in there, makes the grab, and that'll bring up Jack Haggard. Haggard 0-for-2, but did get on board in the second inning with a walk. We need him on board here. Down to our final two outs. Conks trying to avoid their first five-game losing streak of the year. Twice before, we've lost four in a row, but have been able to snap the losing streaks at four. But here we need a rally. So that pitch is low, ball one. The one up is low, ball two. Two balls and no strikes. How impressed are you, Judd, with this Hernando club?
Well, not as impressed tonight as I was last night. You know, but this is a good
ball. It's a good team.
Yeah, they're fundamentally sound, definitely in the field.
Pitch is low, ball three. Good club. Remember, they're a 4A school. If we can get hot, and you never know what happens in the playoffs, and hopefully we'll get into the playoffs. I would assume Hernando is going to win their district. That pitch is in there for strike, but you never know, right?
Yep.
They're at the District 7 4A with Nature Coast Tech, Hudson, Central, South Sumter, and the Wiki Watchy Hornets that we found out about last night. Way outside, ball four, he's walked him. So that's going to bring the tying run to the plate. Third walk issued by Trenton Manor since coming into the ballgame.
Now they do have action in their pen.
And they want to make a move here, and now what is the discussion going on right now? As the infield umpire was over there talking with Trevor Zelch at the bag. Now he's coming over toward the Conk bench. What could be the issue here? And Ralph Enriquez now out on the field, and Drew Haggard's running over from his first base spot. He walked him. So what could be the issue here?
I don't know.
Conk's trying to rally here right now. What is it? He's showing like he's showing Ralphie something with his stance, I guess. What are they?
They gotta change.
Is that Ja'Kai Blake coming in?
Yep.
Coming in. He's gonna run for Trevor.
I think so. Is he hurt? Maybe. I don't know.
That's odd moment to stop the game here, and Zelch is gonna head to the dugout, and Ja'Kai Blake will put on a helmet and run for him. So Not sure what that was all about. Trevor didn't seem injured, did he, Jeff?
I don't think. I don't know.
But anyway, the discussions are over. Let's play baseball here. Conks have runners at first and second with one out for Nate Barroso, who's having a terrific night here tonight. He's made things happen in all three of his plate appearances, and he looks at this one high and outside, ball one. He had an RBI single in the second, an RBI sac fly in the fourth. He worked out a walk and scored a run in the sixth. So a solid day for Barroso getting the start in left field today. The 1-0. That one's right down the heart of the plate for a strike. One ball, one strike. That one is a bit high, ball two. 2-1. Two balls, one strike to Nate. Got runners at first and second. Looks at this one high. Ball three, don't help him out.
No,
walk him, bases
not, yeah.
are juiced. And the winning run will come to the plate. Kai Smith is on deck. If he walks him, I would assume they'll make a change.
I would think. I would have thought they would have made it already. But
the 3-1. Oh, he gets the call that time. And Nate thought it was a little low, but umpire calls strike two. So the count moves full. Three balls, two strikes. The pitch, fastball swung on, and that ball's hit down the right field line. Stays fair, it's trouble, but it'll go foul. Oh.
I know. Last
night that was close.
Last night they had about three of those that stayed just inside the line.
Yeah.
And we get one, ours goes on the other side.
Oh, boy, that would have been nice, but it just tailed foul down there to the right of the 306 sign. So the count remains three balls and two strikes. Everybody goes back to their respective bases. It's Kai Blake running at second for Trevor Zelch. Jack Haggard is over at first. The 3-2. Outside, ball four, he's walking. So the bases are loaded. Blake moves down to third. Haggard up to second, back-to-back walks. And don't you dare go away, because the Conks have got something brewing here with one out in the seventh. And I believe that will do it for Trenton Manor as their skipper Tim Sims comes out onto the hill. So far he hasn't shown that he's making a move here yet. Brings everybody in. Kai Smith is waiting patiently to see what they'll do. Conks trailing by three. We've got the bases loaded.
Don't leave him in there.
He's leaving him in. He's going to give him at least one more batter. So with one down, Kai Smith will have the opportunity here. Got Ja'Kai Blake at third, Jack Haggard at second, and now Nate Barroso just worked out his second walk of the game, is over at first. So we needed these base runners. Now we got to get them home. So Kai awaits, and the first pitch from Manor is low and inside, ball one.
Conk have some patience at the plate for the Conks. Defense is back playing for a double play.
The 1-0. That's a good pitch right down the heart of the plate and the count at 1-1. And I like the approach here. Kai not trying to help him out, force him to throw that strike. Now something looks good, man. Take a hack. Let's do it. Here's the 1-1. Fastball on the outside portion of the plate, strike two. Top of the order, Wyatt Kuhn on deck. One ball, two strikes to Smith. He's been on board twice today. He's worked out two walks. The 1-2.
Slow breaking ball. It's low. And the count moves to 2-2. That first walk Kai had way back in the second inning happened with the bases loaded, and he picked up an RBI. Here's the 2-2. Swung on. Hit back up the middle. The shortstop fields it. Tag second for one. Over to first. Game-ending double play. 6-3 on the double play, and that'll do it. And the Hernando Leopards, a very hot baseball team, just picked up their 17th win of the year, and they complete the sweep of the two-game set against Key West as Kai Smith grounds into the double play that ends the bottom of the seventh for Key West. So for the Conks here in the seventh, no runs on one hit. There were no errors, and two men were left. And that'll do it as Hernando wins here by the final score of 8-5, and the Conk losing streak is now at 5 games. We'll take a break. Don't go away. When we come back, we'll get the Mojo Sports Bar and Bistro postgame show started. We'll put a wrap on this one. We'll hand out some awards and get you set for next week when Baron Collier comes into town. This one goes to Hernando as they complete the sweep with the 8-5 win here at the Rex tonight. We're back in 2 minutes here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WAVK.